Today, we're releasing a targeted proposal that focuses on several of the most urgent aspects of this crisis.
The Senate unveiling a newly constructed, scaled-down stimulus bill for Americans struggling during the pandemic, which would be paid for in part by unspent money in the existing CARES Act and includes proposals for an extra $300 in weekly unemployment benefits, cut in half from the weekly $600, which expired in July, 2 years of tax credits for parents to cover costs of private and homeschooling, and an extension of the Paycheck Protection Program to the tune of nearly $258 billion, just to name a few.
We're going to get the stonewalling of Democratic leaders out from behind closed doors and put this to a vote out here on the floor.
Senators expecting to bring the aid package to a vote on Thursday, but it's not expected to get the 60 votes it needs to send it to the House, where it's already facing opposition.
It's only a check the box so that some of his endangered Republican senators can go home and say, well, see, I tried. But it isn't trying. It's not even an attempt to do the right thing. And Mitch McConnell knows that because he has to satisfy those Republicans in his caucus who don't want to spend one more dollar.
In Washington, I'm Daryl Forges reporting.